this is episode 24 of Waraku Wednesdays. So last year, I made this trip to Michigan State University, which is where I did my master's from. And it had been 15 years since I'd graduated, and I'd never been to campus after that. So it was a really much anticipated visit for me. And there was this photograph that I had taken when I was a student back then, which was this really vast farmland and surrounded by picket fences, or wooden fences, if you would call them. It's a really nice shot. I took it in black and white. It's framed today. It's there in my house. I really love it. One of my personal favorites. And I was really keen to go back to that exact same spot to see how things had changed. And I was anticipating a lot to have changed. I was anticipating the farmland to have been taken over by some building. Definitely not the wooden fences to be there, because it's been 15 years. But once I reached there, I realized that at that exact same spot where I had taken the photograph, nothing had changed. It was exactly the same farmland, it was exactly the same wooden fences, and it was exactly the same frame the way that I had shot it 15 years back. And instantly, my mind went back to that time where I was this kid doing my PhD, not too happy with what I was doing, wanting to come back and start afresh, determined to do so, but extremely uncertain about what the future would be for me. And I remember feeling a lot of emotions back then, nervousness, anxiety, this uncertainty of what would happen to me. Determination, yes, but they were not easy times. And I had this overwhelming feeling last year, standing at that spot. I wish I could go back in time and tell the uncle of 15 years back, everything will be fine. Everything will be fine. And the reason I share this with you today is because these last 24 episodes of Waraku Wednesdays and these last 6 months have been extremely humbling for me as an experience. A lot of you have expressed your appreciation, your gratitude for the lessons that I've shared and how it's influenced you. But an equally large number, thousands, have written in expressing very honestly how miserable they are in their lives right now, how stuck they feel in their lives right now, how nervous, uncertain, threatened, desperate, frustrated they are in their current circumstances. And they are just waiting for someone to help them, to guide them, to mentor them. And I wish I could tell them that everything will be fine, but that would be lying, right? Because I don't know if everything will be fine. But what I would love to leave you with, though, and that's what I tell everyone there who writes in, is try and understand that at some point of time, the only person that you are answerable towards is your own self. And if you don't give the respect that you yourself deserve, everything will always feel as if you're stuck and made to do someone else's job or wish. Don't be in that relationship that you don't want to be. Don't be in that job that you hate. Don't be in that course that you don't love anymore. Don't be in a circumstance that you don't want to be in. So what if you fail? So what if your friends don't like you for that small period of time? So what if your parents don't understand you? So what if you are alone in that? You at least will live life not facing that one word that we all dread, regret. How many of our parents have this insane level of regret where they wanted to do so many things when they were young, and yet they've reached a point where they can't do anything about it? And you are at that spot where the world is your playground, where anything that you do is at your will and demand. You only have to have the courage to go out and seek that in a truthful manner. When you look in the mirror every single day, there are three people that you can see. The strength is you, the competition is you, and the enemy is you. And it's your choice. Are you your own strength? Are you your own competition or are you your own enemy? And that's the choice you have to make today. Stop living someone else's life. Start living yours. We'll be taking a break from Vareku Wednesdays for 6 months. It's been a fascinating, humbling 6 months, and I could not have asked for more love than what I've received. And we figured that we have to take a pause to rethink of how we want to do this, come back with a bigger, sharper, hopefully just as good version, season two of Vareku Wednesdays, which will be launched on the 1st of August 2018. Until then, I will keep sharing my thoughts, my experiences, my journey, and I hope that I can continue engaging with you in exactly the same manner, if not more, than what's already happened. Please keep writing in. Please keep telling me how I can help. Please keep telling me what I should improve on or fix, and I'll be always listening. Until next time, 1st of August 2018, Vareku Wednesday Season 1 signs off. Thank you. Thank you.